Even though there are several things that you have to know and that you have to study in order to be a successful transfer, you know, choosing the right classes, choosing the right professors, making sure your articulation agreements match up with the college that you want to transfer to, you know, whether or not you should work or how to manage your time wisely. There's so many important things that you have to understand. But in my opinion, without this crucial step and crucial thought process, all those is gonna be very difficult. The mindset. You first have to establish your mentality and your mindset before you even step into your first class on the first day of school. Before you sign up for all your classes, before you even attend community college, you have to establish this mindset in order for you to be successful, not only in community college, but just in life in general. So I'll tell you why community college, attending a community college is not only a smarter decision, but overall a much better decision than going to, you know, let's say a mediocre school that you don't really want to go to if you're in that situation. You know, if you're in high school and you apply and you go to a good school, that's great. But this is for those who, you know, they applied in high school as a senior and they didn't get into the colleges that they want to go to, or they didn't get into any single college. So the reason why attending a community college is much better, if you think about it in the bigger sense, in a much bigger picture, is because first off, you save a lot of money. Nowadays, college is getting really, really expensive. I know that when I graduated high school in 2013, if tuition was like 25K a year, that was considered hella expensive. But now, you know, it's gotten to the point where if you're not from a particularly, you know, affluent or wealthy family, you have to take out loans. You have to work harder to get a scholarship. It's very difficult to, you know, pay full and go to college without having debt. This is not like the past. And since college is getting so much more competitive and so much more expensive, a lot of people who even do get accepted to these colleges, they're kind of scared of going because they're like, oh, I got in, you know, into this private school, but I'm not trying to pay 70K a year, which is completely understandable. When I went to community college, I realized that, hey, I'm not gonna be here forever. You know, this is just a temporary start. You know, at the end of the day, your main goal is to get a college degree, a four-year college degree. You get that at the college you end at. So you can start at a community college. You can start at a school that you really hate and you don't like, but that doesn't mean that you're gonna get the degree from the school you started out with. So for me, I started out at community college. It doesn't mean that I got a degree at community college. My end goal was USC, and ultimately USC degree was the degree that I got. And that's the most important thing that employers look at, that companies look at when you do apply for jobs. They don't care, you know, how you started out. You don't even have to write that on your resume. All they care is where you got your degree, which is the most important thing. The second reason on why attending a community college is a much smarter decision is because overall, it is much easier. It is much more simply, it's a simpler curriculum. You know, I could say this from experience because I've attended both community college and a four-year university at USC. The difficulty is pretty big. The difficulty of classes, the difficulty of tests, difficulty of professors and the essays and projects and presentations that you have to do is very different. So by attending a CC, a big advantage that you have is that the only thing that you have to focus is the GPA. That's it. You know, in high school, when you had to apply for college, you had to get a great SAT, you had to get a great GPA, you had to get, you know, some schools they looked at whether you took honors classes or AP classes. Oh, were you in band? Did you do a sport? What was your extracurricular? Did you volunteer? There's so many different things that you have to do, so many different aspects that you gotta fulfill and put on your college application in order for you to be competitive to get into anywhere that's decently good, you know, in high school. But the difference in community college is that they just look at the GPA. They don't really care about what you did. They don't care if you worked. They don't care about your extracurriculars. You do have to write your essays, but it's not weighted the same as in a regular admission from high school. I'm not gonna say it's 100% GPA because I honestly don't know. I don't work at the admissions office. So I don't know how, what kind of percentage it's split into, you know? But what I do know for a fact is that GPA GPA is regarded very highly. I'd say, to be safe, I'd say 85 to 90% is GPA. If you get a 4.0 and you write a mediocre essay, you finish all your GEs, chances are you'll get into a decent college, a top 25 college. But you have to make sure that the articulation classes and the articulation agreement matches with the college that you want to go to, as well as your GEs. And another reason why attending a CC is so much more beneficial and a much easier to transfer out is because a lot of the top tier four-year colleges, you know, Stanford, USC, Berkeley, UCLA, etc., they take a percentage of transfer applicants from community college that they have to fulfill. So for example, if this is like a pie chart, and I'll probably show a diagram somewhere, if there's a pie chart, it'd probably be like 60% regular admission straight from high school, and then 20% transfer from community college, and maybe 20% international kids. I don't really know the specific percentage breakdown, but in a general sense, they have to fulfill that criteria for only community college students. Because you're at CC and it's easier, and the college that you want to go to has to fulfill that criteria, they have to fulfill those numbers, you have a huge benefit, you have a huge advantage of going where you want to go. All you have to do is get the GPA, know which classes transfer, make sure the articulation agreement matches. These are the reasons why, in my opinion, I don't even think it's an opinion anymore, I think it's a fact, why attending a CC is a much better and a much easier way to go into a prestigious four-year university.